guys. Okay, so many of you guys asked for chapter 2 on the Hawk's Sister Ex-Bucko. So here it is. Chapter 3, Quirk Assignment Test, Part 2. The 50-meter dash was so cool. You found it extremely interesting, and it distracted you from your nerves and anxiety. Learning about your classmates' quirks also helped start a conversation with them. You talked to Aoyama, whose quirk was naval laser. It was so particular. And Uraraka, zero gravity, was her quirk. They both were super nice to you, and Shoto was also really glad that you become more comfortable. A frog-like looking girl, and Ida were preparing for the race. Uraraka was standing next to you, when she gently nudged your shoulder, causing your eyes to move away from the mini racetrack setup. So I couldn't help but notice that you and Todoroki are really close. She squealed happily. You haven't actually been introducing to crushes before, so I had no idea what to say. Yeah, he's a good friend, you responded. Frog Girl and Ida finished their race already. They didn't take long, and you missed it. Oh well, Aoyama was the one to speak up to you now. Oh la la, is he your boyfriend? He asked curiously, striking a pose. You were taken aback by this. Your eyes widened and you lifted your arms in front of your chest defensively. No. You misunderstood. He's like a brother to me. Aoyama and Uraraka seemed a little satisfied with that answer, but they were still skeptical about the topic. Aoyama had to go to do his race, so he waited with Uraraka. Your curious eye-colored eyes couldn't help but wander towards Bakugo as he warmed up. His muscles on his forearm flexed and his butt looked so good. Ah, stop it! You can't think this way! You mentally scolded yourself. Uraraka unfortunately noticed you staring at his built form and put the piece together. Utakemi, I didn't realize you had a crush on Bakugo, right? She cooed. This time you couldn't hold back the little blush that crept onto your cheeks. No, I don't. He's an annoying creep that has a bigger ego than his own hair. You tell her with your chin up and arms crossed. Uraraka put a finger to your chest and smirked. Sure, she said in a sarcastic tone of voice. And please call me YN, you asked. She nodded. You bit your lips and continued to watch Aoyama and the pink-horned girl race. You didn't have a crush on Bakugo, because it was way too soon. You just thought he was attractive, but his personality was shit. After Aoyama and the pink-horned girl raced, you decided to start a conversation with her. You walked over to her, standing next to a group of boys you didn't know. You nervously played with your fingers. Hi. You nervously smiled at all of them. They all turned to you with smiles once they realized who it was. Hey, you're the hot girl from the class, the yellow-haired one shouted, while pointing his finger at you. Embarrassed by the compliment, you just nervously laughed and rubbed your arm. The red spiky-haired one smacked the yellow-haired boy over the back of his head and grinned at you while the other rubbed his sore skull. I'm Eiji Kirishima. That's Sarah Hanta, Denki Kaminari, and Mina Ashiro. Sorry about Kaminari. He introduced and gestured to everyone in the group as they gave you welcome smiles and waves. You smiled back. Nice to meet you guys. I'm Wang Takami, but please just call me Wang. And it's the right Kaminari and Kishima, thank you. He smiled. Cutely at them as the boys seemed to blush a little. As you were talking to them, though, you noticed it was Bakugo and Izuku's turn to race. You turned your full attention onto them. Well, more on the hedgehog, but that's not the point. The machine signed them to go, and before you knew it, Bakugo made his hand spark. A trail of explosion left his hand and boosted him forwards, leaving Izuku in the dust. Wait, Why is Suzuku not using his quirk? Well, maybe his quirk isn't useful in this test. You concluded that to satisfy your own curiosity. The race finished, and you noticed that it was your turn. But you didn't have anyone to race. You were the only one to notice, though. Ushima addressed Mr. Osawa. Mr. Osawa, there's an odd number of classmates, so who will YN be racing? Sorry, that was supposed to be Kirishima's voice, but I don't want to read that again. He politely asked. Mr. Osawa smirked and looked at you with a glint of mystery in his eyes. Me? He simply said in all the calm tone.
What?
Everyone shouted. You were so worried, but you should have known this was coming. It was obvious he wouldn't do this to you. Gloping used the words and nodded at him, making his way to the track set up, with him following. You could feel everyone stares at you, though. Once you were in the place, you took off your jacket, revealing a bare back tank top. SFC. I don't know what that means. SFC tank top. Skin toned? I'm really sorry, I don't know what that means. Mr. Sao got into position to, and once the machine signaled to go, you sprouted two beautiful face color wings out of your back and lightning speed. You boost yourself as you push the air back, creating a gust of wind like no tomorrow. Asawa was using his scarf to boost himself, but he still ended up winning. Panting wildly, he stood up with your hands on your knees and wings dropping. Mr. Asawa was also out of breath, but regained his composure quicker. He was smiling at you. You rolled your eyes at him. Now everyone knows my quirk. Right when I thought I couldn't get away with it, he thought. Like a flash mob, your peers surrounded you, asking a million questions and complimenting you. Such a cool quirk, Zero yelled, punching the air. Your wings are beautiful, can you touch them? Uraraka smiled enthusiastically as you stretched out your wings, and she caressed it like it was made out of gold. Well done, Wayan. Mr. Sao spoke. You could see Asuku scribbling down notes in his notebook as Bako just glared at you and walked away to do who knows what. Mr. Sao then cleared his throat. Alright, stop knocking off. Let's get back to work or you all get expelled. He said in a monotone but still deadly voice. At least none of them compare me to my brother. He sighed in relief. You decided to keep your wings out and tie your jacket around your waist. Shadow walked up to you and patted the head of your ruffled your hair-colored locks. Well then, Wayne, he smiled softly. You side-hugged him gently and he hugged back. I'm strong enough to get through this. Okay, that was that part. There's going to be another quirk assignment part. That will be the final quirk assignment part, and it's more chapters. It's a lot of chapters, I believe. It's 21 chapters. So yeah, this was chapter 3. I'll see you guys next video. Bye.